This is the second presentation in a series about coherence in writing. Coherent communication involves clear, logical, consistent linkage from one thought to the next throughout the communication. In this movie, we look at techniques to ensure coherence between words. The words within a sentence should be consistent in their form, their point of view, and the tense that is used to ensure coherence. It tends to be easy to get that right if you're using simple sentences, but as soon as one gets to more complex sentences, it's a lot more difficult. So it's helpful to start with simple sentences so that we can develop awareness, and then we can apply this to more complex sentences. So here's a simple sentence, which is inconsistent in form. Pause the movie and fix it before you proceed. You can download material for these presentations by clicking on the link below, and that will take you to a PDF, which has got notes as well as the passages that are used in these presentations. Here I've got two ways to fix the sentence. Notice the consistency of the use of the form of the words. In this example, we use the present continuous tense. As we can see, each of the words ends in ing. And for this list of words, it makes sense to put to in front of each of them. To jump, to run, to skate. Here's a slightly more complex sentence, which is inconsistent in form. Pause the movie and fix it before you proceed. Here I've given two ways to fix this sentence. Notice the consistent use of the forms of the words in the list in each sentence. Here we use the noun form of the words, and we can see that because we can put the word the in front of each word. The maintenance, the communication. In this sentence, the verb form is used, and we use the same tense in each case, the present continuous. Maintaining and communicating. They're both actions, they both end in ing. Here's an example that I created for my master's thesis. Notice the consistency of the form of all the listed items. Often in tabulated lists, you find that some items are in the verb form and maybe differing in the tense of the verb used. Others might be in the noun form. Some might even be adjectives or adverbs. It's worth spending time getting all the items in the list, whether it be a bulleted list or a tabled list like this, in the same form, and that enhances coherence. Now let's look at consistency of point of view. Here's a simple sentence which is inconsistent in point of view. Pause the movie while you fix it. Notice that first it refers to someone and themselves, and then it refers to you. Here I've suggested two improvements. The first is consistent from the point of view of someone, and the second is consistent from the point of view of you. Here we have a slightly more complex sentence which is inconsistent in point of view. Pause while you fix it. And here's one suggestion of how to fix it. We've spoken about inconsistency in tense a few times, but now let's focus on it. Pause while you fix the sentence. We should either use the past or the future tense consistently throughout the sentence, but not to mix the two. In this movie, we've looked at consistency between words to promote coherence, and that's coherence within a sentence. In the next movie, we look at coherence between sentences. Until then, happy writing, like and subscribe, and leave comments below.